the king. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we are in the fourth day of Navadwip Mandal Parikrama Ki. Our 60% Parikrama Ki. Only 40 more percent Parikrama tomorrow, day after tomorrow. So, congratulations, congratulations, congratulations. So, I'll be speaking on Srila Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur, the last Parikrama he did in his pastime, and the last lecture in his pastime was given in Ritudip, and that has got a very special connection for all of us, because in that, he is predicting who will be the future Acharya, who will be manifesting the prediction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu true. That is Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. So before that, a small prayer, then Bhutir Mahadvir Yahi Ma Puru Vibhu Nirmaya Sete Yada Amshu Purusha Bhunte Gunan Sodasa Sodasa Atmaka Solang Krishna Bhagavan Vachamsi Me Solang Krishna Bhagavan Vachamsi Me Solang Krishna Bhagavan Vachamsi Me Akila Jagat Guru Vachan Se Amar Alankrita Karibara Shamata Tumar Tava Kripa Hoy Mura Kata Shuddha Hoy Suni Asa Bara Soka Dukha Je Guchi Be Mukam Karoti Vachalam Pangam Langayate Girim Yat Kripa Tamam Vande Shri Guru Dinatarine Bharat Bhumi Manisha Janma Hoylo Jar Janma Sartak Kare Karo Parupka. So, Srila Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur in the year 1922 in the most historical place, the most historical meeting, he ordered Pacha Desha Tarine. You young boys, you know English. You should take the message of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and preach in West. Paschata Desha Tarine. And that was 19th that the prediction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Prithvite Achayat Nagaradigram Sarvatra Prachar Hobe Moranam. Make it true, make it true, make it true. And Bhakti Vinod Thakur is Vimla Prasad. He said, yes, mother, I make a promise. I take a sankalpa. I take a vow. I will make it come true. I will make it come true. Now years have gone. And this is his last lecture, and he's now going to finish his pastime, and he's begging to his disciple. Thousands and ten thousands of his disciples, brahmachari disciples, sannyasi disciples, vanprastha disciples, grahastha disciples, and this is the last lecture in his life. I gave a promise to my mother. who in this saintly assembly is going to help me fulfill this promise, this vow, this sankalpa? So everybody he was looking at. He was looking at his grihastha disciples, everybody kept their head down. He was looking at his brahmachari disciples, they kept their head down. There was absolute silence, pin drop silence. He was looking at his sannyas disciples and they were also kept their head down. Don't worry! In this saintly assembly, there is one person who is going to make this prediction, this vow, this sankalp come true. And Srila Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur was looking at one direction. And in that one direction, there was one brahmachari. And his name was Nayan Ranjan Brahmachari. And Nayan Ranjan Brahmachari is the brahmachari, is a Babaji later on, who reconstructed or built the temple of Sri Sri Gaur Gadadhar ki Jayadev Goswami past times, where we saw Nayan Ranjan Babaji Maharaj. So he was thinking, Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur, my Gurudev, Acharya is expecting me and blessing me that I will fulfill this prediction. And he was feeling really very happy and was feeling very blissful. Then he realized, wait a minute. Few minutes before the meeting started, the conversation, the pravachan started, there was Abhay Charan with his son. He was sitting behind. And then he realized, Srila Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur is not seeing him. He is seeing over him and looking at Abhay Charan Aravinda Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. There was pin drop silence for 10 minutes and for 5 minutes there was eye-to-eye contact, one-to-one connection with Abhay Chanar Ravinda Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. And Nayan Ranjan Brahmachari understood who is going to fulfill the prediction of Prithvite Acheyat Nagaradigram Sarvata Pracharobe. And that is His Holy, His Divine Grace Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki. So that was the confidence which Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur had in his pure loving disciple Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. How did Nayan Ranjan Brahmachari understand that no, it is Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada? Because Nayan Ranjan Brahmachari at that time, he understood few years ago in Chaitanya Math, we all know where is Chaitanya Math? Mayapur, Chaitanya Math, Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur's Sanyas Ashram, Bhajan Kutir, Shri Shri, Girdhari, Gandharvika, Girdhari Ji ki Jai. Shri Shri Guru Gauranga Gandharvika, Shri Shri Radha Girdhari Ji ki. That is the worshipable deity of Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur. So it was around 2 o'clock in the afternoon. It was around 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Srila Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur was in his sannyas ashram, and there are many sannyas disciples who are having a conversation with Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur. And at 2 o'clock, Bhakti-sandarbha Thakur, he finishes his meeting, and once the gate is closed, once the door is closed, Bhakti-sandarbha Thakur, Sanyas Ashram is in the second floor and everybody was sitting, and once the door is closed, only after 3:30 the door is open. And in the assembly at around 2:05, one grihastha comes with suitcase. At 2:05 he comes to the gate And from gate he reaches the second floor brahmachari and he pays obeisance to all the sannyasis and all the brahmacharis and everybody said he will not get a chance to see Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur. But at 2:10 the gate opens. Everybody surprised. Na bhuto na bhavishya. This never happened in the past nor will happen in future. And he welcomed. Abhay! Come in. Abhay, 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 Abhay. Hey, who is Abhay? And this grahastha with suitcase goes in. Then everybody understood. In that assembly, Nayanranjan Brahmachari was there. Then he understood. Abhay is not an ordinary personality. And then there was a conversation between Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur, the door was open and nobody knew what was the special conversation which happened there. Only one person knows, that is Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur, and the second person who knew is Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, and the third person was Sri Sri Guru Gaurang Gandharvika Sri Sri Radha Girdhari Ji K. And no fourth person knew that. What was the conversation? And at 2:45 the door opened and the grahastha with suitcase is coming out, again paying obeisance to all the brahmacharis, all the sannyasis. Everybody is looking, who is he? Who is he? Who is he? And Nayanranjan Brahmachari noted, he is not an ordinary personality. Again, same Nayanranjan Brahmachari and His Holiness Sridhar Swami, senior godbrother of Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, and senior another brahmachari, Narottam Das Brahmachari, and Srila Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur, they were together. Srila Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur had a casual talk with Sridhar Swami. Sridhar Swami, you are a scholarly personality. I want you to go to the Western world and preach the message of Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ki. No, Gurudev, no. I am expert in Bengali. I can speak little English. But don't give this order to me. If you give this order to me, then it will be third offense against the holy name. I will not be able to fulfill this and I will commit an offense. Please, please, please. Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur says, okay, okay, okay. This is only a request, not an order. Then Sridhar Swami. Then he looks at Narottam Brahmachari. Narottam Brahmachari was such a powerful Brahmachari that any Bengali village he goes, the whole village will chant, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. He was very powerful and he said that, Narottam Das Brahmachari, yes, you are the one, you are the one, you are the one who will fulfill this prediction. Then again, Narottam Das Brahmachari in a humble mood said, no, 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 Gurudev, don't give me this order. Please don't give me. I can preach in Bengal and Bengali language. Please don't send me to Pashchata Desh. Okay, don't worry. It was a casual talk. It was a request. It was not an order. But I know in this assembly there is one person who is going to fulfill this order. And he was again looking at His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki. And Prabhupada was smiling and Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur was smiling. And Nayanranjan Brahmachari was saying, wow, there is some special connection between these two manjaris, Nayan Manjari and Prabhupada. And so he understood that in Ritudip, the last lecture with Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur was giving, who was he looking at? Which Prabhupada? One big round of applause for this wonderful Brahmachari. Hello. So, there is a special connection between Srila Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Thakur and Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ji. And this happened here in Ritudip. And that was the last lecture by Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And after that, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada took over, and we know the history. And we are the part of history. We are here to make history, not to read history and cram history. We are here to make history. Bharat Bhumi Manasa Janma Hoilo Jar. Bharat Bhumi Manasa Janma Hoilo Jar. Repeat. Janma Sartak Kari. Karo Parotkar. So we have to do that Parotkar. We are here to make history, not read history. So we will take this process seriously. And this wonderful pastime took place here. So we are all here at present, Bharat Bhumi, and we are all Bharatvasis. All of us are Bharatvasis. The Bharat Bhumi, Manusha Janma Halaja. This Bhumi of Bharat is so special, so special, so special. What to speak of Manusha? Even an elephant can become a wonderful devotee and preach all around the world. Bharat Bhumi, Hati Janma Hoilo Jar, Janma Sartak Kari, Karo Paropkar. In this Bharat Bhumi, Gajendra the elephant became a devotee and he made others devotee. In this Bharat Bhumi, Rasikanand Goswami's disciple, the elephant, he became a devotee and made others devotee. Bharat Bhumi, Panchi Janma Hoilo Jar, Janma Sartak Kari Karo Paropkar. In this land of Bharat Bhumi, a crow called Kakbusandi, a bird called Garuda, they became devotee and made others devotee. In this land of Bharat, even a fish can be delivered and can deliver others. Bharat Bhumi, Machli Janma Hoilo Jar, Janma Sartak Kari Karo Paropkar. We all know Shripad Ramanujacharya, after honoring Mahaprasad in his when he washed his hand in this water pond, many fishes, they got what mukti? Swarupya mukti. They become Bharat Bhumi rat janma holo jar. Bharat Bhumi rat janma holo jar. Rat in Hindi, Sanskrit is called Bharat Bhumi Chuva Janma Hoilo Jar, Janma Sartak Kari Karo Paropkar. Remember Kartik, remember that Kartik Puja, that rat who took that deep and ran, he got the Swarupya Mukti and went back home, back to Godhead. So this Bharat Bhumi is so powerful. Ramanujacharya's first disciple, Yadav Prakash, he was an insect in his previous life. This is a long pastime. If you all allow a few minutes, then I can recite. So, no time. So, Bharat Bhumi Manasa Janma Haila Jaya Janma Sartaka. He was an insect in previous lifetime. What to speak of him? Maitra Rishi. He was an ant in Bharat Bhumi. Bharat Bhumi Ant Janma Haila Jar Janma Sartaka Kare Karo Parupkar. So, Bharat Bhumi is so special. What to speak of ant? What to speak of elephant? If we are human beings, so how much we should take advantage and make our life successful and make others' life successful. So this is a very special Bhumi, very special Bhumi, very special. And Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, he made wonder. He came from Bharat, he went to America, France, and he went to Russia, and he also went to many other different places. So America Bhumi, Manusha Janma Hoilo Jar. America Bhumi, Manusha Janma Hoilo Jar. America Bhumi is such a place that people drink and drink and drink. A small child in mother's womb is also drinking. Good, 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 good. He is saying that last life I was a drunkard, I had to work hard. But here my mother is drinking and I am also drinking. That too upside down. So, so Bharat Bhumi, America Bhumi, Manusha Janma Hoilo Jar, Janma Barbad Kare, Karo Nasha Char. But, glories to Srila Prabhupada, glories to Srila Prabhupada. He went to America and he made hippie into happy. And those happies are coming here and making us happy. And Prabhupada went to France. France is such a place where everybody is into vibhachar. You know, Prabhupada said the most beautiful women in earth, they are in France. So France is such a place. France, bhumi, manusha, janma, hoilo, jar. Janma, barbad, kare, karo, vabichar. But glories to Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada went to France and made these France vases into bhaktas, and they are now coming here and making us bhaktas. And Prabhupada just passed by China. He made few Chinese devotees. China, bhumi, manusha, janma, hoilo, jar. Janma barbad kare, karo masachar. Anything which is flying or moving, they will eat. That too raw, not even boiled. But all glories to Srila Prabhupada, all glories to ISKCON, all glories to all wonderful ISKCON gurus and devotees are making China bhumi. And these Chinese devotees are now coming here and making others also devotees. And in Italy is known for gambling. Italy bhumi mansha janma hoilo jar, janma barbad kare, karo juvachar. But Prabhupada went to Italy and made Italians into devotees. And these Italian devotees are now coming and again making India, bringing glories to India. So all glories to Srila Prabhupada ki. Navadwip Mandal Parikrama ki. ISKCON Sansta ki. ISKCON Sansta devotees ki. ISKCON Sansta future mein aane wale devotees ki. Nita 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 Gaur Hari Premanande. So this is the place where Bhakti-sandarbha Sansta Thakur recognized Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, and this is the place where we Gaur Gadadhar and Gaur Nitai is recognizing us. We are the ones who are going to make the prediction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Bharat Bhumi Mansa Janma Hole Jar Janma Sartak Kari. True. So we are here to make history, and to make this history we have to take all the mercy and then go to our respective place of preaching and give the mercy. And to get the mercy, the only qualification is to be humble. Humble, humble. Be tolerant, no Vaishno aparad and no Vaishno ninda. Give respect to everyone and don't expect any respect. In this mood, we can take the maximum mercy and go back and distribute the mercy and come back again, like Bhakti Charudeshan Maharaj said, and recharge next year and again and again. So let us take this process seriously. Let us take maximum mercy and make our life successful and make others' life successful. Srila Prabhupada ki. Navadwip Mandal Parikrama ki. Gaur Hari Premananda.
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day. And don't forget to like and share our channel.